I'm calling from Olumi Ibadan.
Tijani Hassan, Olumi Ibadan. Okay, go ahead.
Firstly, I want to thank God for my life. Also, I want to wish him a happy birthday.
Thank you.
I'm more than 3 years, Baba.
Thank you.
I also to Chairman Agidigbo, Yemiya Mutak. So, I think on Baba analysis on how we can use sport to combat crime. You know, from the eyes of the meat. So, from my calculation here, about 180,000 youth so be taken out of our streets. So, if I thought the government can listen to Baba, and I remember you guys said as well, you know, our main point is that we like to put wrong pegs in right holes. And also, I've asked you to learn, so and that's why, and that's the result we are getting. And Baba, last time you were on the hot seat, you said that 3 million of tobacco is owing you about $20,000. What?
$20,000.
Yes. That's
yes.
No, what are you making to retrieve the money?
My brother, that is one of my weaknesses.
Mm-hmm.
Money is not the first thing in my life. It's not only, I worked in some states in Nigeria where they are still owing me some money. Even here, 3SC, they are still owing me 3.1 million. But I don't stake my life for money.
Mm.
And if I have reasons to thank God for feeding me and making me
hello?
Healthy and comfortable.
Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon. Your name, please.
Yes, this is Michael calling from Bodija.
Michael from Bodija. Go ahead, sir.
Yes, thank you very much. Welcome to your living day.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Sir, I'm concerned about shooting, sir. In fact, since the beginning of this season, I've not missed any of the home parties. I was listening to you at a particular time, even on this station too, you said something about how cities can even stand on its own without even looking for government funds, sir.
Yes.
Shooting
Stars
is a brand. It's a big brand in Nigerian football.
Very good, my brother.
Yes, Chibuli Binde is a brand in Nigerian football.
Oh, that's
I
another.
I want to ask this question, sir. Who is marketing Shooting Stars? Since the promotion of Shooting Stars, by now we should be seeing sponsors even falling on top of each other. How to brand this? I want to appeal to Governor of this state to please let us put this politics aside. Being in Tivoli BJ, he's not going to be the coach. Let him market this football club for us. Tivoli can make billions of naira. What do you say?
Yeah.
Tivoli will be with billions of naira. Tivoli can make money. Government has a lot to do. So I want to appeal to the government to please. There are some politicians in that place. There's no one this one to come in.
Thank you, Mr. Michael. Thank you, Mr. Michael. Thank you, Mr. Michael.
In 2002, I got this type of sponsorship, particularly from Gulda.
Okay.
I knew how much I was taking from them every year.
Wow. Okay.
In 2002. Well, it depends on how you organize your things and how what knowledge you have about going out for these things. That you have a lot of I've had some experience in this country. From what I write, what I say in the papers, some people are trying to create their own image from my own brain. Well, let them go ahead.
Well, very quickly, Chiva. Oh my God! Hello. Hello.
Yeah.
This is Agidigbo 8.7, the hot seats.
Yeah, hello. My name is Bode from Australia.
Bode from where?
Yeah, Australia.
Sectarian?
Tivoli Binde.
Sorry, please, I want to get where you are speaking to me from.
I'm calling from Australia. Australia.
Australia.
Watching online.
Australia. Okay, sorry. Sorry. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I want to talk to Tivoli Binde.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I want to talk to Tivoli Binde. My name is Bode Ajayi. I'm from Oshun.
Yep.
What Baba said is not the truth. In 2002, Baba discovered Femi Opapomi.
We went there with a lot of young chaps. Wow. We enjoyed the match in Japan, Korea.
That is my style, my brother.
Baba discovered this, our goalkeeper then, the best keeper we ever had. This guy.
Oh my God. Wow. That guy called in from Australia. Sorry, we lost him. And,
well, if I may put in a little on this.
Yeah.
I said that is my style.
Yeah.
I believe in developing football, in developing young players, building them into stars. I was saying it earlier on, there are stages. The first stage is to identify the talent, not star. Anytime I handle a team, I get into a team, I don't look for stars. I look for talents. It is my responsibility as the coach to develop that talent into star.
That's true. Hello?
Hello.
Yeah, good afternoon. This is Agidigbo 88.7. Yeah. Your name, sir?
From Ologunaru.
Your name?
I'm Bakari from Ologunaru.
Bakari from Ologunaru. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, hello. Thank you. Thank you.
Sorry, sir, your line is bad. Maybe we'll have to try again. I'm sorry about that. Sorry. Please try and see whether you can reconnect. Well, I got some messages a few minutes ago. Can you please help me bring them up so I can go ahead? Now, we discussed, someone was raising a vital point, you know, that this issue of finding sponsors, you know, for the team. How can you try again to reactivate such? How can you help?
Now, the first step is this. If
sorry, sir. Hello?
Hello.
Yeah, we have to allow these callers, yeah. Your name, please.
My name is Suleiman Sharif. I'm calling from Onara.
Suleiman Onara.
Sharif, I'm calling from good afternoon, sir. Baba and the studio.
Good afternoon.
So, happy birthday to you, sir. May you live long.
Amen.
It's standard, sir.
And so you too.
I want to ask you this question. You know, the system that we are, our government are operating in Nigeria, is really doing its way. That's sport activities. Like 3AC now, thank God that the present government have been in the stadium, but they are now holding a night match. What is your own perspective on this? Because, you know, what we are facing in Nigeria, you know, some lovers of sports, instead of them to encourage their local team, they prefer and by supporting international team. So what is your own perspective, sir? Thank you.
Did you get that, sir? No, he's saying that it's like we are being encouraged now to watch local, like the 3SC, you know, organizing, allowing them to play their matches at night. You know, I think it's to showcase the beauty of our stadium and to make people appreciate that there is no time that you cannot play or watch soccer as long as the floodlights are there. That's what's your opinion about that?
Well, as far as I'm concerned, sports is a 24-hour job.
Good.
Even if you play in the morning, what matters is how you prepare your team.
All right, sir. Hello?
Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Your name, sir? Where are you calling from?
This is Comrade Ismail Adedamola. I'm calling from Bashorun.
Comrade Ismail, you are on to Agirigbo. Please move ahead, sir.
All right. First and foremost, I want to extend my wish to the daddy in the studio. Mm-hmm. Happy birthday, sir.
Thank
and
you.
And I say to you that may the year of your people is greater than the year of labor.
Thank you.
Then, amen. Amen.
Then number two, I also want to use this opportunity to felicitate with the founder of Agidigbo in person of Olaji Oriyomi. Happy birthday to him too. And long life and prosperity.
Amen.
And may he has many cause. A good cause to celebrate.
Amen.
Lastly, sir, I don't know what is your relation.
Oh my God!
Oh wow!
So,
What is your
relationship with the current minister of
sports,
sport and youth development in person of Mr.
Sunday Dare?
And okay. Is there any national agenda that you have for our our youth, as far as we hearly say that we are more talented in the Africa. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much. When the minister came in, he was relating with me. We were exchanging telephone calls and text messages.
Sorry, Chibodimiri. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead, sir.
But as soon as people got into him, I was cut off. So right now, I don't think there's any relationship between us.
Maybe we should consider that it's a bit busy. Maybe he's still going to go back.
Yes. Let's put it that way.
Hello? Hello? This line keeps cutting off. Hello? Hello? Okay, let me go back to my Facebook page very quickly. Alimi Matthew, Alex says, well done. Adebayo Fatima says, well done. Adeyinka Adekunmi says, I congratulate our papa. I wish him happy birthday, long life and prosperity, new age with grace, good health, and God's protection. During the time when Baba was handling the Super Eagles, I always had confidence in the then Super Eagles. But since we are putting, can I see them all? He says, yes. Since now that we are putting what? Can we read the rest? Well, if not, at least he has made his point. Well, there's someone on the line again. Let's quickly take this one. Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, good afternoon. This is Agidi Boyd 8.7. Huh?
Remy Bakker is back.
Oh, Remy Bakker again. Okay. Okay. Yeah.
I just want to remind Baba about his plan. That is what he did with shooting. And the blueprint, he said he wanted to put across that people like that. Maybe you didn't remember that to tell the listening public. Because that's the area where Baba is not happy with those who wanted to chop by chop. So, please, how can we now get it right? And where do we start in order to get shooting back to sports club? Your dream wanted it to be.
Thank you, Mr. Remy Bakari. Thank you. And I think you answered that. I have a rider to that, but you answered that first.
No, it's a very simple thing. You were asking the other time whether the government has a part to play. Yeah. Do we need to have a sports ministry? Of course we have to. Because the sports ministry will set a standard which all others will follow.
We'll follow.
It's the same thing. If this government is determined. Okay, let's see. When I was with the Western Region Sports Council, I told you, we had several zonal centers all over the place.
No.
We had qualified coaches who are going around in all sports, not just football. And but we have lost all that now. I of present, even the Oyo State Sports Council, I'm sorry to say this, I don't think they have up to 5 football coaches in their employment. Some of them are on contract. I mean, we are not taking sports seriously. And that is where the government comes in. Not at organizing clubs and competitions. No. Competitions are supposed to be organized by sports associations.
Okay.
But how do we get the sports associations? That's what we are talking about. How do we get them? And that was why I gave an example of Shooting Stars. If I had people buying shares, then from those who buy shares, we have their directors and so on. If the people in charge know what to do.
Now, let me ask you this question, sir. You see, people are very happy that this government in Oyo State today has succeeded through its efforts to get the Shooting Stars back into the Premier League. And they do not want the Shooting Stars to go back or down again.
Relegation. God forbid.
God forbid, amen. Now, I think you owe this country a duty. You owe Oyo State a duty, like you owe Osun State or every other state in this country a duty to leave a legacy. You have something. I don't want you to like wait. Well, the Yoruba say, "Bigere jela abagba," you know. But But let's
look at it from this angle. I dip my hands into my pocket, come out with some pieces of gold and sell them to you, and you shook your head, you say you don't want it. What do I do?
That gold is what I'm asking you to bring out now.
No, haven't I shown what God has given me to the people?
Okay. So if you are asked, you will release.
Well, let's pray to God.
Oh my God.
If you say you don't want it, I put my thing back into my pocket.
Okay, I think it's a great eye-opener this afternoon on Agidigo 88.7 on the hot seat that what Nigeria needs in sports to develop and how sports can be used, you know, to reduce crime rate has been enumerated very decisively. And I think governments in Nigeria...
When you are talking about crime rate, you are also talking about employment.
Employment, right. Hello? Hello? I'm sorry, your line is not good enough because we can't really catch what you're saying. Sorry, please. Yes, sir. You were talking employment... Sports.
I was talking about
development and
even moral building.
Yeah.
You want to. You have a lot of things wrong in this country, social problems, and I have just explained how you can use sport to change this situation. And if you appreciate what I have been talking about, you will agree with me that no amount of money spent on such things is a waste.
That's true.
Because you are building the future. You are making the present comfortable. So, what is governing all about?
Hello?
Yeah. Hello, this is Joseph once again. I want to ask Baba a question.
Joseph, yes, okay, go ahead. Okay, go ahead.
Yes, Joseph from Aromi, I want to ask
yes.
one
question.
Yes. Last time Baba came, Baba said he has a good relationship with the new Super Ego coach, Guevon, Austin Guevon.
Yeah, Austin
Guevon. I want to ask, Baba said something now in his today's analysis that during his own time that he didn't like using foreign players, that like discovering talent.
Yes.
I mean, the gifted young ones and prepare them and develop them. So I want to ask, since Baba said he has a close relationship with Austin Guevon, and now the man is like going to the old ways of in which the former of Nigeria Super Eagle was doing then, inviting foreign players. So. What is Baba's advice to him now? Because the man is like inviting foreign players now, and which Baba said he has a close relationship with him.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Joseph.
Let me correct one impression.
Yeah,
I have never said I hated foreign based players, but if they are coming in, they have to fit into my system. That's all. You don't come in with the air of a superlative, whatever. That is the problem. And the problem in coaching is this. When you are coaching a team, football is a team game. And which means your major objective is to make the 11 people play on the field to behave like one man. So the understanding must be there. If you bring a player from Manchester United where they are playing a different system from Chelsea, from Oxford and all the rest of them, you need time to blend them into a team. And that is the problem we have been having with our national team here. You invite foreign-based players 2-3 days, 1 week. You will not produce a team. You have a pack of star players.
Now, the guy is putting up an advice that because at least Guavon is someone well-known to you and who discusses with you, that you might need to help him by
Every one of them know my system. I told you when he was appointed as technical director, he traveled to Ibadan, to my home in Ibadan. We had discussion, and we have been having discussions since then. But the problem we have is this. The moment people know that he's relating with me, he's in trouble. It sounds funny, but that is what has been happening. The moment I told you, when the present minister, when he came in, he was, you know, discussing with me on telephone, chat, and so on and so forth. But at a point, he cut me off.
He stopped picking your calls?
Yes. Stop picking my phone. Stop communicating with me. And since I'm not a job seeker, what do I do?
Now,
Eguavan, as I told you, is very close to me. I coach his brother, his senior brother.
Wow.
Monday, Eguavan.
Monday, Eguavan.
Okay. So, I respect his knowledge and practices. But the problem is, he's under pressure. Under pressure. Some of these foreign coaches you are talking about were managed by some so-called football administrators. So they want them to be there, whether he likes it or not. I'm telling you what I have gone through.
Okay.
Whether he likes it or not, they want him to bring the player they are managing into the team.
Okay.
That is the problem. It's personal interest above national interest.
All right. Very quickly, you've told us how things worked out as a FIFA instructor. And can we have an insight into what you did majorly when you were with CAF, also as an instructor? Let me see whether we can pick this call before we go into that. Okay. Hello?
Hello.
Hello, good afternoon.
Hello. Yes, I just
Yes.
Okay, number me and no one to confess.
Okay, that's right. The bang boy to Lori radio. We are care woo it to no law, Kelly Mobuya, Epi Wally. It to no law yato, seem TFA, we to Tanati law. To what dear Coco Mitan Shirwe, Elikwe, Eshe. Now, CAF, what would you say were your major achievements with CAF? What were the duties assigned to you, and what were you able to accomplish?
No, I told you I got into CAF. It was their technical director then, El Wash, who suggested, because of the interaction he had with me in Cote d'Ivoire in 1984, that I should be brought. I was brought in, and when I got in there, the man sat me down and said, "Chief, this is our business together. How do we improve Nigerian, African football?" We sat down and planned how to have developmental programs, coaching courses and all the rest of it. And then how to assess African football. And that was what I was doing for about 25 years. We'll go out and watch African football, analyze the performance of every player.
Every player.
Yes. When you are analyzing the performances of a player, you are looking at various angles.
Okay.
Psychologically, is he fit? Intellectually, is he fit? Physiologically, is he fit? Technically, is he fit? Medically, is he fit? Tactically, is he fit? And in what areas? When you are talking about physiological fitness, then it is there you will be considering. How do you decide whether he's fit physiologically or not? Is he fast? Does he have strength? Does he have stamina? Is he flexible? Is he agile? All these are, physiological areas of fitness. Are we doing that in Nigeria? Then when you talk about, I was talking about psychological fitness. You are playing a match at 4 o'clock this evening. Your best striker was sacked by his landlord at 12 noon. Is he going to play well? No, or he was sacked by his girlfriend. They've been together for about 5 years. And you want him to play well in the afternoon? Then you may be asking me, what is coach's business in that? The business is this. That shows why every player must be so close to his player that he knows when he has a problem. You see your players, oh, John, why, you are not looking well. What is the matter? If you have been relating well with him, he will have confidence in you. You say, Kochi, don't mind Ojire. It is that girlfriend. Then you know how to talk him out of that type of problem. You are doing your job as a coach. Now you talk about physiological fitness. Is he fast? Does he have strength, stamina, and so on and so forth? We have to look into all these areas. Are we engendering this into our players in this country? And that is why I keep saying, now some many years ago when I started talking about analyzing our matches, you know what the football authorities did? They started appointing journalists to go and analyze technical analysis of matches. Journalists to analyze technical fitness. Maybe. Instead of training technical analysts and send them to all our matches. A lot of things are getting wrong.
Hello?
Baba?
Yes, sir.
Who will now bail the car?
Sorry, sir. Your name first.
Remy, calling back.
Okay.
Who will bail the car? How, where do we go from here? We want a standard sports club in Oyo State. How do we go about this?
That's
my own problem.
It is very simple, very simple. But depends on the authorities, especially the government, to decide. Give us the guideline and we'll follow.
Okay. Now, you were on CAF.
Yes.
And I want you to say, for issues of posterity and for the records, what would you say were your major achievements in CAF as an instructor? You said you traveled, you worked on developing sports in Africa.
Yes.
So, what will you say you achieved? Because I see some African countries beating Nigeria anyhow. So
that is what I'm going to. That is why. That is part of the result with modesty. Part of the result of my effort. Go out to all these countries. Unfortunately, when I go to these countries, they don't handle me the way Nigerians handle me. They believe, well, somehow an authority has come. And they are now using all these things we have been teaching them to come and give Nigeria problems. In Nigeria, but Jesus the Christ said it, there is no prophet without an honor, except in his
home place.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Hello. Hello. Who's on the line, please? Okay, I think we lost that. Very quickly, I want us to go into some, or you go into some reminiscences. When you said you started, hello. Oh, come on. When you said you started. I think the game of football is I hadn't come into this world by then. And so then the likes of the big names we used to, you know, hear in the past, you know, like Taslim, Tunde Balogun, all this this WNDC star, you know, I can't remember now. You will know them.
That goes to prove what I've said. That Nigeria is endowed with football talents, but we are not discovering them.
Did you play with those ones?
Balogun.
Mm.
It was Balogun who got me into coaching. Taslim Balogun.
Okay.
After playing in Nigeria, the national team, I have the history, everything.
How did the name Thunder came about?
Because of the power of his shots.
Okay.
Thunderbolt.
Okay.
Yes. And I still claim up till now that that man is the greatest footballer Nigeria has ever produced. I was relatively close to him.
Yes, I was trying to remember the Jofa Yomichu. Okay.
Yes. In 1957, the Nigerian politicians went to the UK to discuss about Nigerian independence. It was there that sage, the late Chief Obafemi Awolowo, convinced Thunder Balogun to come back to Nigeria. And he brought him to Ibadan as the chief coach of Western Region Sports Council.
Wow.
In 1961, this man, let me go back. He came back in 1957. In 1958, he was going around the then region, which extended to Sapele and all the rest of them. Then he discovered me at Ilefe, and he was encouraging me to come and play in Ibadan.
Okay.
There was no money in sports then. By then, 1958, I was already a grade 3 teacher. So I resisted. But when I was going to do my grade 2, fortunately, I got admitted at St. Luke's College, Ibadan here, Malete.
Okay.
So we became so close that probably closer to him than his up till now. This morning, his children have sent some messages to me this morning. I'm still part of the family, so I know him very well. So when he could not get me, but when I came to St. Luke's College, Ibadan here, we became very close. When I became captain of St. Luke's teacher training football team in 1961, I was inviting him to come and help me. And it was probably because of me, he got organized the first organized coaching course at the Liberty Stadium, 1961, July to August.
My God.
And he said, I must attend. And he kept telling me, he said, look, my friend, I know you have certain qualities more than I have that could make you a big coach. I said, you qualities, what qualities do I have? And he encouraged me. I had to take permission from our principal then for about 3 weeks, attending the coaching course at the Liberty Stadium, 1961, July, August. Over 20 of us attended, but 12 of us came out with certificates from that course. It was Tunde Balogun as the chief coach who got that course through the sports council. And then national chief coach, Beth Halevi, he was an Israeli, was brought in to run the course. We had then late Ayo Adeniji, who was my immediate boss. We had people like Amos Ashitu there running that course. The Lunge brothers were there. Bayo Ali was there. And a lot of others. I still have the photograph. So that was how we got organized, and Western Region was moving. Tunde Balogun, Teslim Akane Balogun. Arawa. Arawo. Akoro Omo Dada.
I remember the late Chief Lekun Salami.
Oh, yeah.
The
yeah.
father of Sutin. And honestly, you cannot write 3SC without talking about Baba Lekun.
He was the founder.
Good. Tell me more.
So how can you talk about Shooting Salami without talking about Lekun Salami? And he was a forthright man. That was a man who gave me a lot of opportunities in my life. When eventually, let me tell you a funny story.
Please do, sir.
In 1976, I was sent to Germany for a coaching German A license course. As soon as I came back, I was posted in Oyo, the Oyo Zona area. Then I took my annual leave, I think about August or something like that. And then they were looking for me with a letter of assignment to Water Corporation, because Shooting Stars and Water Corporation qualified for the National League. So they assigned me to handle Water Corporation. My boss, Alan Hawks, was handling Shooting Stars. When I got to Water Corporation, the Water Corporation officials were grumbling. They said, you see, we said it, they don't like us. Where do they get this coach from? We have Lagbaja there, we have that there. Why did they give us this? I pretended as if I didn't hear them. So the following morning at training, I told the boys, I said, boys, what's your problem? They said, they don't like us. The sports council don't like us. I said, what have you achieved for them to admire? Have you achieved this? Have you achieved? They said, no, okay. Are we ready? They said, okay, sir. Four teams qualify for the...
Can you remember some of the boys then? In the Water Corporation? No. Okay, go ahead.
They are all my good boys.
Yeah.
I will talk about that later. Now, what happened? We got to Lagos. There were four teams who qualified for the finals. Shooting Stars, Water Corporation, Better Insurance, and ACB Lagos. it was going to be a double-edged whatever. So we got in there, and somebody got the authorities to fix water versus shooting as the opening match, so that water will come back home quickly. But we went out and beat Shooting Stars 2-1.
Wow.
2-1. We went on and on and on and on. After the second round, we eventually emerged second. Shooting Stars first. But Shooting Stars had to defend the cup they won in 1976.
Six, yeah.
So water qualified for champion African champion cup. That was how the thing went on. Then we are now talking about Chief Lake and Salami.
Mm-hmm.
The late Chief Lake and Salami, may so rest in peace,
Amen.
Was the man who gave me a lot of opportunities in life in football coaching. Because the strong supporters will go to him to complain that they didn't like the way I was training, because I believed in rudimental fitness. If you don't know how to handle the ball, how are you going to play a good match? So when the supporter, because they didn't understand, when they saw me doing this elementary thing, they will go to Chief Lake and Salami, and Chief Lake and Salami said, look, this man is winning matches for you. Why don't you leave me alone?
Hmm.
See? And so that was how I get on. So, and he was somebody who was very, I don't know how to talk, but what football was virtually in his blood. And he could do everything. There was a time he lost his son in the hospital.
Hmm.
Huh? He went to the hospital, brought out the corpse, and you know where he went to?
Mm-hmm.
Football training.
Mm-mm.
He left the corpse in the car. And at the end of the match, he called his supporter and said, the boy is dead, go and bury him.
After the match. That passion is...
It will be difficult to come about another person as passionate as Chief Lake and Salami on football.
And also heard that he could spend any amount he had.
He wouldn't mind becoming penniless, spending his money on football. It was like something that I can't explain it. It was too much.
Let's try and recall some of the discoveries you made, talents that you made or you discovered for Nigeria in soccer. Can you remember some of them?
Well, when it comes to this, I don't want to single out anybody. So it's not usual of me to begin to, but let me mention some.
Mm, we need some,
Rashid Yekini, okay. How did he come up?
Okay.
I took the national team to Kaduna in 1983 December.
Okay.
It was there some Yoruba people told me there was a Yoruba boy who was playing textile, whatever. And that was how he got into the national team. Several of them like that. When I was going to the World Cup, it was unknown players. In 1983, my Green Eagles, how many stars were there? You remember somebody was mentioning some names a little while ago? Because I believe in developing young boys. Maybe as a result of my training as a teacher.
Okay.
I trained up to grade 1 as a teacher. I spent 6 years in different teacher training colleges. And I taught for about 20 years. So developing young ones was in my blood. It had become part and parcel of me, and I will always want to do that. I told you, we were talking about the stars I brought up. In 2002, when I was going to the World Cup, the national team had collapsed. I had to go around looking for players. It was at a league match, Nabe Okuta, Julius Baga versus Enyimba, that I discovered Vincent Enyama. Vincent Enyama was in goal for Enyimba. And after watching him for about 30 minutes, I told my assistant, James Peters, I said, follow that boy. That's our number one goalkeeper. He said, oh, guy, did you know him before? I said, I'd never seen him. And if he takes that jersey off now, I won't be able to recognize him. We followed him. He eventually became number 5 goalkeeper in the world.
Hmm.
Several like that. And I respect stars, but I don't believe in them. Yes. You have to play into my system. Full stop.
A lot of people criticized your style of is this style of coaching now, or the position you take, you know, when games are on? You know, we see a lot of coaches running up and down, but
they
will sit down.
These are coaches who have not done their job at the right time.
I see.
The match time is not the coaching time. The match time is the time for you to sit down, analyze what is going on. The opponents and your team, what do you have to put right? What are the opponent's strong points which you have to, you know, work against? And they say two things cannot occupy the same place at the same time.
Yeah.
While you are running up and down, can you do this critically well, analyzing? It's not possible.
Maybe because you don't have enough coaches. Because you once told us that a team should have more than
one coach. No.
Okay.
Contrary to what you are saying, when I was going to the World Cup, I appointed five assistants. Gave each one of them an assignment.
Five assistant coaches.
And Nigerians were criticizing me. Some even said it was because I didn't know what to do. That was how I collected five people. When I was in Brazil,
yeah,
I was working with the national team, Tele Santana then. Each time they went into the field to train, you will have not less than 10 coaches. And everybody will have his assignment. Look at the areas of fitness I told you about of a player. You can have a coach in charge of this area of fitness, so that he will be particular on what you want him to do. At the World Cup in 2002, the international press asked me that question, and that was the answer I gave to them. And I knew some of the big coaches in the world who stopped jumping up and down. Sit down, analyze, and see what you are to correct and what you are to maintain. If you have done your job, your job at the right time, you don't need to keep jumping up and down during a match. That is the time when you are supposed to be serene, quiet, and watch, so that you will be able to analyze what is the problem of each player. I've been aware of that criticism.
Oh, I see. Anyway, I think at this point...
No, it's like this. When I said maybe my teaching experience influenced my attitude in coaching. If you have a class of finalists in the secondary school and they are going for their school certificate examination, can you go to each of the pupils and tell him what to write during the examination? Can you do that?
No.
Okay.
Well, the hot seats, we have to come to a close on this program. Let me thank Adeyemi Bakare, who's been on the audio console, and engineer Samsudeen is lending a helping hand. My producer, Zainab, Sani, right? And Sekinat, Yusuf, thank you very much for your support. Once again, I'd like to thank Chief Adegwe Odimbide, Baba at 84. Congratulations once again on your birthday. All the while I've been expecting our chairman, Alajori Omyamzat, who had said he was coming here to be part of the program, and to also say congratulations to you. I wouldn't know, some things might have cropped up, and I think he will find time to
I appreciate that.
Yeah.
And we will get in touch with each other eventually.
So thank you very much. Well, on Agidigbo 88.7 FM, Ibadan, Oyo State, Nigeria, it's the hot seat, and my guests this week, and for the second time, has been the former chief coach of the Eagles, the Super Eagles of Nigeria, seven-time coach of the 3SC, A man who served FIFA for 20 years and CAF for 25 years. The man who took soccer to more than 40 countries in Africa to develop African football, Chief Festus. Again, a name he doesn't, he said he has dropped it. I don't know why, but that's what really comes to mind. Let me apologize again, Chief Adegboye Odibide, the OC Balogun of Mudakeke. Once again, on behalf of management, we say a big thank you to you, sir, for coming.
Thank
Wish you.
Wish
you happy birthday. God bless the remaining part of your life. We wish you good health, strength, and God bless you, sir.
Thank you very much.
I remain yours sincerely, for you can do nothing against the truth, but for the truth, I am Olaolu Olatunwosu, signing out until next Sunday. Good afternoon.